What about Mississippi State, though? I mean, Mike Leach, he brings in KJ Costello, the transfer from Stanford. They're trying to put in the air raid offense. Like, that's not something that typically looks all that pretty in year one. Like, that's an offense that depends on reps. And now, how many reps are they going to get? It's not like they're able to coordinate together.
Yeah, like, I think that's going to be fascinating because, and for a number of reasons. First of all, fortunately for Mike Leach and the new coaching staff, they're not inheriting some sort of pro-style system. At least Joe Moorhead had more of, like, it probably would have been tougher to make this transition from a Dan Mullen offense even than a Joe Moorhead offense. But Joe Moorhead still isn't truly air raid. And so the challenge is real. That said, like, so KJ Costello, I we'll talk at some point about this. I did a piece, or Brad Crawford for us at 24/7 talked to me and sort of took my list of the top quarterbacks in the SEC returning. And I actually had KJ Costello number one on my list. A lot of people disagreed with that, but you know, part of my reasoning believing that KJ Costello was, I think he's really a good fit for the offense. And I think you can step in as a quarterback in that offense and be really successful really early. The problem is all the pieces around you have to be functioning at a really high level for you to be able to step in and be successful really early. Gardner Minshew was a summer enrollee and at Washington State and was finished fifth in the Heisman voting. So the quarterback coming in the summer, I think, was going to be not devastating for Mississippi State. I think what's more interesting and probably the bigger challenge for Mississippi State is, in a lot of ways, Joe Moorhead did some good things in Starkville. I think one area where he really whiffed was wide receiver recruiting. I went back and looked at, let me rattle off these names, bud, and tell me who are these guys you're excited about. This is the three classes that Mississippi State brought in at the wide receiver position in recruiting. Devontae Jason, Stephen Guidry, Ja'Quarius Spivey, Brad Cumbis, Cameron Gardner. That's the first year. Javonte Payton, Quinn Torber, Keziah Pruitt, Isaiah Zuber as a grad transfer. That's year two. And then the year three, the guys that he left Leach in this last class, Malik Heath, Jaden Wally, Caleb Ducking, and then Leach went out in the second signing period and got Rufus Harvey, who I actually think is a really good player, who's kind of a sleeper guy. Like, that's for an air raid offense that is, I think it's so critical to have a really strong wide receiver group. That's a bad group that they left this new staff.
And you know, specifically, let's think about what the types of players some of these guys are. Like some of the names you listed off, a Guidry, a Heath, a Jason, I feel like are dudes who do have some athleticism and they are able to win physical battles, right? They can come down with the ball. Are any of those guys, in your mind, like really great, precise route runners? Is Leach going to be starting from scratch here in terms of guys who really know how to get open and understand the finer intricacies of route running? I don't think so. And that comes with reps, and those reps are not happening now in spring for Mississippi State, which is, I think, to your point, right? Like, the guys that they have are not that talented, and then the fit that they have of the guys is also maybe not ideal.
And not only that, but yeah, and I agree. I think that the fit is, like, the body types aren't separators. They aren't guys that are route runners, to your point. And you know, the air raid route tree isn't too complex, but it's also, but you'd have to have some guys that have some movement skill in space. And I don't know that this roster is full of those types.